Never remain when you're not appreciated. If you do stay, if you do hang around, when you're being disrespected, when you're not being loved, when you're not a priority, and when you're not valued, who really is to blame? The other person or you? If you don't know the answer to that, then you're in worse shape than you think you are. If nobody has told you before, I tell you, if you're in a relationship, respect is far more important and valuable than love. Romantic love is a myth, of course, because it's transactional. We've talked about that before. But we all have our needs, so we need to be in a relationship with the opposite sex. And in such situation, if you're not valued, respected, made a priority, never remain. Never remain. If you do, you're the one to blame, not the other person. You want to go somewhere where you're welcomed. Remaining in a situation where you're not valued and respected and are a priority is like going to a party that you're not invited to. Would you do that? Do you have that low self-respect that you would go to a party where you're not invited? Or you go to a place where you're not wanted? Or you hang around someplace after your welcome has been exhausted? Do you want to put yourself in that situation? And that is the same as remaining in a relationship when you're not valued, when you're not respected. Look at that beautiful hummingbird. Sign from above. And believe me, you know when you're respected and you're wanted and you're valued, and you also know when you're not. These are things that cannot be faked. If someone disrespects you, if you need signs, if someone disrespects you in public or in private, but especially in front of others, they only need to do that once. You can be excused if it happens for the first time, but not if you allow it to happen for the second time. You should walk away. That's it. That's the end of that relationship. There's nothing she can say or he, no apology that would make up for that. If someone disrespects you in front of others, that's it. That's the kiss of death. That's the end of that relationship. If you hang around after that, then you're the one to blame. You've heard that old saying, some people say it's Scottish saying, fool me once, shame on you. Fooled me twice, shame on me. It's very true. If somebody does that for the first time and you're not, it's the first time you're experiencing it, okay, you can be excused. But if you allow it to happen again, it's all on you, my friends. Never remain where you are not welcomed. Never remain when you're not respected. It's so much better to be alone than to be in a bad relationship or in a bad situation. Don't you agree? If you've experienced that, then you know what I mean. Have you ever gone on a bad date and a world of relief comes to you when it's over? And you realize how nice it is to be alone and do things on your own terms and not be in an uncomfortable situation. It's the same in a relationship. When you're not respected, when you're not wanted, when you're only being tolerated, why would you stay in that situation? Only a person with low self-esteem, low self-respect, and a true low opinion of self would remain in a situation like that. So don't do it. If you automatically have high self-respect, high value for yourself, a person who stands his ground and will not allow himself to be disrespected, you've heard this, you've heard the saying, which is very true, is that you determine how people treat you and respect you. You set the tone. At first, it really should be in your demeanor and your overall body language. But if someone doesn't read that and they disrespect you, it's up to you to set them straight. Then they know. You know, like a kid that tries you. I don't know if you have been around kids, you know, when they try to, pick up your phone or touch something that they're not sure they should be touching, and they're looking at you while they're doing it to see your reaction. It's up to you at that moment to set the tone, to tell them that's not okay, that's a no-go zone. And that's how you should be with the world as you step out of the house each morning. You set the tone of how much people respect you, how much they can push you, how much they can get away with you. You set the tone. You decide how much respect you get in this world. If someone disrespects you, you quickly let them know that, hey, not with me. That's not going to work. Because if you allow the world, if you allow people to push you around, believe me, they will. If you allow people to take advantage of you, they sure will. And do you really blame them? People often take the easy road, the easy path, you know? Just like a criminal who goes to a house that has no alarm system and no owner with a gun. They want the easy path. You want to make yourself an impossible target in this world so you won't be attacked. And also in a relationship, you want to make yourself the one that's won't be allowed to be disrespected, won't be allowed to be mistreated. And you should quickly set the tone, whether it's on a first date or in a relationship, with an ongoing relationship, whatever. If someone steps out of line that they haven't before, you have to quickly nip it in the butt. Quickly let them know that's not going to work. That's a no-go zone. Then they won't try it again. Believe me, they won't try it again. People are always testing you. From the moment you step out of the house, everyone and everything is testing you. Just like a child is testing you, people are testing you too. You go to a restaurant, they give you a bad table. You tell the guy, this is not going to work. They either give you a better table, you say, well, that's all we got. They say, well, okay, goodbye, see you later. Don't accept second best. This is basically what I'm telling you. Do not accept second best. I could be wrong, but I think it was Winston Churchill who said, a funny thing happens when you decide to accept nothing but the best for yourself and in life. You only get the best. So it's up to you. You set the tone. You decide what you'll accept. Is good enough good for you, or you only want the best? You decide. It really works, gentlemen, no matter how much, and ladies, no matter what your income level is. You have yourself, you have your dignity. You don't need a big bank account. No matter where you stand socioeconomically, it's up to you to set the tone and decide how you're treated in this world and what you end up with in this world. All the best. Till the next video.